Why have Prince Harry and Meghan chosen St. George's Chapel? Harry and Meghan will say I do in May at St. George's Chapel, which is nestled within the grounds of Windsor Castle, in just a few weeks. Here's the lowdown. Shortly after their engagement was revealed, it was confirmed the wedding between Harry and Meghan would take place in May 2018. On December 15 last year, Kensington Palace confirmed the ceremony will be held on Saturday, May 19. In a statement, Clarence House said, "Her Majesty the Queen has granted permission for the wedding to take place at the chapel. The royal family will pay for the wedding." It has been announced that floral designer Philippa Craddock will provide flowers that will include white garden roses, fox gloves and peonies. It has also emerged that the royal couple will have a lamb and elderflower cake made by pastry chef Claire Tack, owner of the London-based Violet Bakery. The couple will tie the knot at St. George's Chapel at Windsor Castle. Charles and Camilla had their televised blessing there in 2005, and it offers the couple a more low-key venue than Westminster Abbey, where Kate Middleton and Prince William got married. St. George's Chapel can accommodate 800 guests, whereas the Abbey seats 2,000. Harry and Meghan have said they're looking at ways to make their wedding an event that members of the public can feel a part of. Meghan Markle's dad Thomas plans to walk her down the aisle when she marries Prince Harry, according to her half-sister Samantha Markle. During a television interview, when asked by broadcaster Matthew Wright if her father would be attending the wedding, Samantha replied, "Yes, he is. God forbid unless a plane crashes through his roof, he'll be there one way or the other." St. George's Chapel, completed in 1528, is set in the lower ward of Windsor Castle, one of the most famous and iconic landmarks of the British royal family. Due to its setting within horseshoe cloisters and the Henry VIII gate, the chapel will also offer Harry, Meghan and their famous friends and family some privacy on what is sure to be a major global news event. Following the ceremony, at least part of the reception is likely to take place in St. George's Hall, a grand 180-feet-long room within Windsor Castle, which is often used for large state banquets. In recent years, Windsor Castle has also played host to Harry's father Prince Charles and the Duchess of Cornwall's blessing after their civil ceremony in 2005. While in 1999 years Prince William and Harry's uncle the Earl of Wessex married Sophie Rees-Jones. Prince Harry and Meghan Markle's wedding on May 19 will be shown on television. It has been announced that planes have been banned from flying over Windsor on the day of their wedding. The couple will marry at midday and at 1 p.m. they will travel through Windsor in a carriage. The carriage procession will travel along a route including Castle Hill, High Street, Sheet Street, King's Road, Albert Road, Long Walk and back to Windsor Castle. Harry and Meghan will then return to a reception for congregation guests at St. George's Hall. In the evening, Prince Charles will also give a private evening reception for the couple and close friends and family.